Hello, welcome to the Great Outdoors RV. My name is Mate.
I'm Ryan Speck. Today we're going to be taking a look at the WILDWOOD X-Lite 171RBXL.
This is a great unit. This is an entry-level price with lots of extra features on it, actually. Well-built, has 2x2s every 16 inches, just like a house would, and 5/8 inch tongue and groove plywood decking, a walkable roof, 12-year warranty on the roof, actually.
Right.
So lots of really good construction and a lot of cool features. We're going to start off with the outside and then run into the inside.
Again, one of the most important things, if you've been watching our videos, I always tell you, is knowing what your tow vehicle is capable of and knowing what the trailer weighs. This guy comes in just under 4,200 pounds dry weight, kind of has a ridiculous cargo capacity because it has a gross weight of 7,521. That's like over 3,000 pounds of cargo. You're never going to put that in here, but it knows that keeps you nice and safe knowing that these axles are capable of hauling your family, your friends, and all your gear.
One of the reasons why it has such a high GVWR is because it is a tandem axle. A lot of things in this size could go single axle or tandem axle. They chose to go tandem axle. That's going to pull a little bit better as you're going down the roads too.
That's right. Now your gross rating is really just telling you what your axles are capable of. So as we move along, this is something I don't see on anything else in this price range. Little magnets to hold open all your doors. Everybody's still sticking with the old plastic clips that get really brittle, or if you forget they're there, you snap them in half when you go to close your baggage
right.
door. And you do have pretty good storage here.
All the way through.
Yep. This is a Murphy bed unit, which a lot of campers, when you have a Murphy bed unit, you sacrifice that pass-through storage area, but WILDWOOD figured out a way to give you both.
You do have nitrogen-filled tires. That means they're gonna handle better, brake better, the life of the tire is gonna last a little bit longer. And back here, you'll notice that you do have 12-volt heat pads on the tanks themselves. Now, these are not an enclosed underbelly, but those tanks are rated down to negative 11 degrees, which is great. You also have a backup camera location here, so if you decide to add a backup camera, you can get one of those through our parts store. You'll also notice this is kind of an arched roof.
Right.
You wanna talk about that, Ryan?
Yeah, a little bit of a barrel to the roof. That is gonna help, you know, with water shedding. It's gonna require a little bit less maintenance than kind of a flat roof where you can worry about water pools getting up there. And I do recommend checking the seals on that roof at the beginning of the season, end of the season. Just make sure they're nice and soft and you're probably fine.
That's right. Over on this side, this is some more storage that you have to work with. These come up, so if you needed to access your water heater, you can do that. You also have bypass valves on the water heater themselves. And then these actually are electric jacks. And look how fast those go. This must be a new type because they are not normally that fast.
Yeah, those are pretty darn quick there.
Yeah, that's about twice as fast as the ones from last year.
Yeah, that's absolutely true. And we also have a really nice awning on this 171RBXL. It's a Medic awning, so again, it's probably gonna be a little quicker than the average awning out there. Let me just run that puppy out so we can get a look at that. Yeah, look at how fast that awning's even going out.
Yeah,
that's nice upgrades.
I didn't know that they made all these nice upgrades. This is one of our newest 19 and a half, would you call it?
Yeah, so this is something new out of the X-Lite plant. All the features that are gonna be on your 2019 and a halfs and your 2020s moving forward are on this particular coach, and we're kind of discovering them for ourselves along with
yeah,
you.
Yeah, this is kind of fun. Another thing that people have really enjoyed is the new solid step. This is super nice because it's not bouncy anymore like it used to be, a little kind of iffy when you went up there. You're like, yeah, I hope I didn't gain too much poundage over the winter.
Over the holidays. So, yeah. And this simply folds up. This is one of my favorite parts of these, is they're not outside exposed to the road elements and the
yeah.
salts and the mud and everything when you're going up and down the road. They fold up inside the coach. Only one moving hinge here instead of several moving pieces. A lot less to go wrong.
Right. We also have a power front tongue jack on this. This also has the solar port, so if you decided to go solar, you can go that route very easily now.
And here's the other side of that pass-through storage area. A little bit bigger baggage door on this side. And then this guy here is just the manual override crank for that front power tongue jack that Mate has just mentioned. Let's go on inside and join Mate and check out some of the interior features on this X-Lite Wildwood 171.
All right, come on in. We'll show you what the inside looks like. So this is the Murphy bed and the dinette and a rear bathroom. We want to show you how this Murphy bed works. And you're done. That's how you set up your Murphy bed. So if you were worried about time setting it up, tearing it down, it takes you longer to go to the bathroom than to set this up.
It really does. And another thing that's nice about the Murphy bed thing here, when you pull that release lever over there.
So right here, guys, just so you know, there's a release lever. And so you just unlock that.
So with your traditional pass-through storage, you have to either get to it from that side of the camper or that side of the camper. With the Murphy bed, you can actually kind of tilt the couch up a little bit and get to all that storage from inside the coach. So that's a nice feature. And I was just mentioning to Mate, the cushions on this thing are so much more plush than they were last season.
This is like a nicer foam or something going on. So, and I like that they put this backer on the
back. Dresses it up a little bit.
Yeah, absolutely. Just a little bit nicer. You do have hanging storage on both sides, and they've finished off this look inside your closets, which is kind of cool too.
And I did add some USB ports, so you got 12 sides. USB ports and 110 outlets on each side of the couch and or bed.
Man.
Storage down below also. Again, this accesses the area of the pass-through that you can get to from the outside.
Yep. On both sides. You also have a flip-up counter space here, so if you want a little bit more counter space, you have it. Roll-up window shades, emergency exit. And you'll notice this window opens in a way that even if the rain is coming in here, you're not gonna get everything soaked. High-rise sink faucet, a drying rack slash more counter space, depending on what your use is.
And that's a good size sink, a nice big double basin sink for all your dishes and stuff.
Yeah.
And I really like the new stainless steel look they've gone with the Furrion microwave and kitchen hood. It's a really clean look, a pretty good size microwave there too. I mean, you do several different things in there. You've got a really nice cooktop again with that glass cover for extra counter space.
And does that have a built-in spring for that
It's got a little spring in there that just kind of helps assist. Because a lot of times you get people who don't really realize which way it goes. So this just, you know, makes it all easy. And then a pretty good size oven down below. Again, a nice glass cover on the front. You used to never see that, and it's more of a residential look. And then you've got your double fridge. So this is a gas electric refrigerator.
In fact, we are one of the only people doing the gas electric and the heated holding tanks. Other dealerships will not be doing those two features.
Yeah, most dealerships are going to be getting either a residential or a 12-volt fridge. Doesn't really work well for the applications that most people use them for here in Colorado.
Yeah, because if you're not plugged in all the time, which the whole point of going camping is to get away from it all.
Right.
And I felt like it wasn't a good choice to have it plugged in to keep your food from spoiling. So we are the only dealership that are accommodating us doing the gas electric fridge and the heated pads. Again, Colorado, if you want to go early season, late season, we already have a shortened season. Mm-hmm. So to be able to do that and make sure your tanks aren't ruined, a great option.
Right, and I'm sitting here in a pretty good size 4-person dinette as well. And I want to point this out, you still have your really nice roller shades, but look at the size of this window. Huge window right next to your dinette, and this is facing your campsite side, which a lot of people don't think about when they're looking at campers, but it's better to have your windows facing you than your neighbor's campsite. Nice overhead storage as well, pretty good amount of cabinetry, and it goes all the way across, and right next to that, you've got your built-in stereo.
This has HDMI, USB, aux in port, as well as Bluetooth, so you can do all this from your phone if you want, and you're good to go. You can control both your inside speakers and your outside speakers just by pushing a few buttons.
Then over here where your entertainment center's at, there's a backer built into the wall here for your TV. But I really like this. It's, if you decide not to do the TV, you've got a real clean look. Not all your hookups just on the side of the wall. They actually hide those back in the cabinetry in here so that you can just pass through this little hole and hook them up. But if you're not doing the TV, which you're out camping, hopefully you're not watching too much TV while you're out camping, unless the weather drives you in, and you've got a nice clean look here. Sliding into the bathroom, this is a really cool feature. You've got a ton of wardrobe space here. Look at all that. Right above the outdoor storage area that was above the hot water heater that Mate showed you is where this is located. Pretty good amount of room too around your stool. So when you're sitting down doing your business, you don't have to worry about your knees running into the shower or anything. Some good storage here, an actual medicine cabinet hanging on the wall. And then I'm gonna slide into the shower here so I can roll in and get a better shot of this. But we've got a really nice glass enclosed shower here that magnets together to keep all that water in here. Nice. And then another really cool feature in this one is you've got some linen storage right here. So not only do you have that wardrobe closet, but you've got all this for all your towels and all your linens and stuff. So they've packed a lot of features into this little guy.
So that was the 171RBXL X-Lite Wildwood. And as you can see, there's not a lot of entry levelness to this camper.
Right, and as blown away as we were by a few of the things that they've added this season, I think you'll be just as blown away. So if you like the video, make sure to share in the comments section. Give us a call with any questions you may have, 970-313-4337, or stop by the dealership. Come lay eyes on these guys yourself. Check them out. It does a whole lot level of justice to them that you don't get through just a video and pictures. Our address, 3511 West Service Road in Evans, Colorado.
You can also find out the price of this particular camper in the comment section or in the description. So click on that and I think you'll be impressed.